Although we use passwords almost universally, very commonly, there are plenty of problems with passwords. People have been predicting the demise of passwords for a long time because of these problems, but they sort of refuse to go away. So what are some of these problems? For passwords to be strong, and by strong we mean harder to guess, they need to be long. And they need to have these upper, lower digits, special characters, and things like that. Increasing the space of possible passwords, well, that increases complexity for users and usability suffers. Even if we have good passwords, there are problems with sort of the trusted path discussion that we had. This is sort of related to that. Phishing and social engineering attacks, really, users don't authenticate who is really that they're giving their password to. So there's this idea of mutual authentication, you trying to convince the system that it is really you, it's Alice. Do you assume that the system is the true system? Do you ever ask the system to authenticate itself to you? In particular, in sort of if you're using a remote service, it's your bank or someone like that, how do you know it's really your bank? It could be someone else who just looks like your bank. And those are the sort of these phishing attacks that we have. Unfortunately, once a password is stolen, it can be used many times. It's not a one-time use sort of a thing, and they can gain access to your account again and again. And the way we address that is by having policies that say you must change your password every 90 days or every 6 months or whatever it is. Of course, usability is going to suffer because of that. And finally, humans are humans, and they have a hard time remembering lots of passwords. These days, it's not just one system that we have. You have your bank, you have your mail, you have various merchants, e-tailers, and things like that. So you have lots of passwords to remember. You don't want to have the same password everywhere, because when one gets compromised, vulnerable to sort of all your services that you access, somebody can get to them with that one stolen password. So if you're going to have different passwords, well, that's going to be hard for us to remember so many of those passwords if they're really hard to guess and they're long and complex. Well, although there are many problems, there are, of course, some best practices when it comes to passwords. So when it comes to sys administrators, it's obviously the password should never be stored in the clear. So we only store hashed values, and we use salting, random salt, to avoid the problems, multiple users having the same password and things like that. We have to limit access to the file where these passwords are stored, the hash values are stored. So shadow files we talked about and so on. And we want to use a function here that is not fast. We have to do it only once, isn't it, when the user logs in. We don't need to run it a million times. So it doesn't have to be fast. It can be slow. On the other hand, someone doing a brute force attack has to run it again and again. They have to run it millions of times. So using a slow function actually is helpful, and current implementations actually do that. They use slower one-way hash functions. What users can do is, there are a lot of password managers these days. You're talking about having a lot of passwords, one for each different service you want to use, and hard to remember all of them. Well, password managers actually can generate, you know, complex high entropy. We didn't talk about the word entropy, but entropy is sort of, high entropy means it's harder to guess. So they can have these difficult to guess passwords, and they can keep track of those. You basically have one strong password to access the password manager, and they can keep track of your other passwords.